Hey, welcome everyone. My name is Peter and I'm a technical trainer here at SAS. In this video, we're gonna learn to import a CSV file into SAS. And I actually have two different CSV files we're gonna use so we can see some different options. So let's get started by first finding the location of our CSV file. So I have the two here. We're gonna start with cars.csv. I'm gonna right click, edit with notepad, and just take a look at the file. That first row, we can see we have the column names. I want you to look at drive tran. That has a space in it. We are actually gonna fix that with an option. We can see the data starts at row 2. And if I scroll down, we can see it all down here. I'm gonna exit out. And I'm gonna copy the location of this file. And now I'm gonna start and I'm gonna tell SAS where that file is. We're gonna use a macro variable called path, and we're going to specify scsv import. The next thing I'm gonna do is set an option to help clean up column names as they come into SAS. SAS has certain rules for column names, and we want that CSV file to adhere to those. We can use options, valid var name equals v7. Now we can import that file. I'm gonna start with PROC IMPORT. The first option I'm gonna use is the data file option, and that's gonna tell SAS where that file is. And in quotes, I'm gonna use the path macro variable, which specifies scsv import folder, and then the file name, cars.csv. So now SAS knows where that file is, we need another option. The out equals option. This option is the SAS table name from that CSV file. I'm gonna name this cars. The next option I'm gonna specify is what type of file this is. We're gonna use the DBMS equals. And then we're gonna use CSV. But you can see there's a list of other options that you can use. And then the last option I'm gonna use is the replace option. And all that replace option does is says if a table named cars exists, it's gonna overwrite that table. You might not always want that option, just be aware that you can use it. Now I'm done with my import procedure, so let's run our code. So we can see we've imported the file. Check my log, make sure I don't see any weird notes. So we have some notes, we brought 428 records in from scsv import cars.csv. Let's go back to our output data. I wanna expand the first column. I'm gonna zoom in a little bit. And let's look at these values. We have Acura, Audi, BMW, and I'm gonna get down to here. So let's look at row 56. We have cattle. Well, that should be Cadillac. If I scroll down, row 65 and below should be Chevrolet, not Chevre, and so on. So why are these values truncated? I'm gonna go back to the top. I'm gonna zoom out just a bit and explain what PROC IMPORT does. So what it does is it scans the first 20 rows. So it's gonna scan these first 20 rows. And by scanning the first 20 rows of each column, it's gonna make an assumption on what type that column is and what length it needs. So if I look at that make column, I can see Acura is a length of 5, Audi is a length of 4, and then at row 20, it ends with Audi. So SAS thinks make should be character with a length of 5. But we saw that some other car makes are longer than 5 characters. So we actually have to fix this. And if I go to my log, I scroll up. Here you can see what PROC IMPORT did, and it used a data step with the infile statement. Think of PROC IMPORT as just the quick, easy way to bring in a CSV file. If you want a lot more control and flexibility while doing something like this, you would want to use the infile statement. There actually is some links below that you can check out about the infile statement. If we look at that first in format make 5 dot, we can see that's giving it a length of 5. So I actually wanna fix this. So I'm gonna go to my code, and I'm gonna use another statement called guessing rows equals max. What this does is SAS is going to scan every row and every column and make a better estimate on what it needs. So now let's run this. I'm going to expand the make column and I'm going to scroll down and we can see our values are not truncated anymore. So the guessing rows equals max is a great statement to use when using PROC IMPORT. Just be aware if your data is hundreds of thousands or millions of rows, it will take a bit longer to use guessing rows equals max. And if I go to my log, scroll up, we can see my data step with the infile statement, and now we can see the values have changed here. So let's go back to my output data, and again, we brought this in correctly. Let's go to the code. And now I'm going to bring another CSV file in. And let's start by taking a look at that file. And I want to bring in cars underscore noheaders.csv. I'm going to right click. We'll edit with Notepad and we'll take a look at this file. We can see there's some differences here. First, I can see there's a comment at the top in lines 1 through 3 that says this was created by Peter at this date. And we can also see there's no column headers. And in row 6 is when the data starts. So we actually have to change how we're bringing this in. So I'm going to go back. And I'm actually going to copy our PROC import. I'm going to paste it below so we can see some of these differences. The first thing I want to do is change the file name. So cars underscore noheaders.csv. Out equals, we'll call this cars2, dbms equals CSV. We're going to replace, and we're going to keep guessing rows equals max. I'm actually going to run this. Let's take a look. So we can see our column name starts with an underline and then var2 through var15. We can see it brought in rows 1, 2, 3, and 4, the blank, and then that note. And then we can see it's starting bringing in the data values here at row 5. So we have to adjust a couple options. And I'm going to start by first telling SAS, don't bring in column names. So get names equals no. And then the second option I'm going to use is data row equals 6. This specifies to SAS to bring this in, let's go back, at row 6. So let's try this again. And we can see it looks a lot better. We have our rows. We still have an issue with column names, which we'll take care of in a second. Let's go to our log, 428 records. And again, we can see our infile statement here. I'm going to go back and I'm going to actually fix these column names and we're going to actually use the column names we need. I'm not going to change all 15. I'll do a couple so you get the point. To change the column names, all you need to do is use the rename equals option. So we're going to use this in the out equals option. I'm going to start with rename equals. And then we need to pass a list of column names to change. I'm going to start with var1 equals make, var2 equals model, and then we'll say var3 equals type. Let me just back out a tad here, and there we go. So I'm going to change 3 of the column names. You can change the remainder and give it some practice. We're going to run our import procedure. And now we can see we've started to change those column names because our CSV file didn't give those to us. And again, I can continue for the remainder, but you can practice that on your own. So let's review what we looked at. We looked at 2 different import procedures, one for a basic CSV file with column names and our data values starting at row 2. And then we looked at another CSV file with no column names, a comment at the top, and data starting at row 6. So we've played around with some of these options in PROC IMPORT. If you found this tutorial helpful, please like the video. You can also subscribe to our channel above And if you want any more information, please take a look at the description below. And if you have any questions, please add them in the comments.